The opening of Benjamin Britten's A Ceremony of Carols, sung by the choir of King's College, Cambridge, led by Sir David Wilcox. And Greg, your husband, can turn the radio safely back on now, Emma Thompson. You're the only person ever to have won an Oscar for screenwriting and also have won an Oscar for acting. The only person. Does that mean that the industry in Hollywood is more scared of you than they would be a normal actress, if you like, because you get it, you know the gig, and you are in control, and you're not dependent upon other people to deliver the scripts?
I don't know. They're very welcoming.
Right.
They're very keen on me to write, because, of course, good writing is hard to come by, and treat me well as a writer. And it's nice not to just be on the end of a phone waiting. So I'm quite lucky, I think.
It seems like quite a sort of seamless journey that you made from being a student to then being... I mean, you won a BAFTA for Tutti Frutti, didn't you? Yes. To being this terrifically successful, bright young thing. You even had an agent at Cambridge. I mean, you were spotted and it was...
Yes, yes. That's right. Footlights was one of those hunting grounds. And yeah. We did, all of us, get an agent when I was about 19, I think. And he, Richard Armitage, was very good because... He was the one who always said to me, you've got to do your own thing, you've got to do your own thing. He said, you wanted to write that comedy series, you've got that opportunity, you must do that. And I wrote a comedy series that was torn to shreds.
I'm glad you bring that up, because it almost seemed a point at which the press delighted in saying, ah, yes, you think you're good, do you? Well, we'll tear a strip right off you. I mean, it was very poorly received, and a lot of the critics really laid into it.
Yeah, in a very, very personal way, yes. As well. It was like a personal attack. You can't do this, you shouldn't be doing this, you should never have been given the money, you are awful, awful, awful. It was real hatred from a lot of journalists, a lot.
And did you think about chucking it in? Did you think,
No, I just thought, well, maybe I should act.
Right.
I mean, the option was there, you see, because I think that was part of the problem was I'd won the BAFTA for Tutti Frutti and Fortunes of War. It was for both of those things. So I had been recognised, if you like, for serious acting. And now I dared to try my hand at comedy, which is what I'd always intended to do. Yet, it's the reason I got to write Sense and Sensibility, because Lindsay Durand watched this show, which was put out in America at about 3 o'clock in the morning, you know, and she happened to see it and said, I like that sketch. I think I'm going to ask this woman to try. She seems to be able to write in a vernacular that could be Austenian, but she's also funny. And that's why I got that job.
Let's have some music then. What's next?
Oh, now, this is Intilimani. In 1973, when the coup happened in Chile, Victor Jara, who was a Chilean freedom songwriter, was murdered. And Intilimani were all musicians who all knew Victor Jara and were exiled from Chile for 15 years and went all around the world playing their charangas and the Chilean instruments, but also learning instruments from other parts of the world. And sitting there listening to these voices and the thrang of these guitars just fills you with courage.
Intilimani and Candidos. You were never afraid to step out of the box of being the actress.